Eye Glaucoma Presents, a video series sponsored by Allergan, Glaukos, Ivantis, Nova Eye, and Sight Sciences. I'm your host, Dr. Constance Okeke, glaucoma specialist and cataract surgeon, and we're here to get to the point and share surgical learnings and pearls in MIGS. In today's video, the MIGS device featured is the Hydrus Microstent by Ivantis. One of the most common challenges seen with MIGS in general is having a poor angle view during surgery. The fundamentals begin with knowing what is a good on-face view, seen here, where all angle structures are in great front view. A poor view is a top-down view of the ideal entry site, which doesn't allow for the full visualization of the angle anatomy. How can you get a better view? Well, for this procedure, it may mean rotating your chair slightly or changing the height, maybe shifting your microscope to set yourself up ergonomically. It may mean rotating the patient's head more or having them look in a certain direction by your command and holding it there. Also, you should magnify your view so the speculum is not seen and you have a clear view through the center of the gonio prism. Another very important point is that when implanting the Hydrus Microstent, it is vital to select the proper entry target. The best location is 3 to 4 clock hours away from the non-radial corneal incision being used for the entry of the stent. This will allow for the curvature of the stent to glide easily in the angle. Since my primary corneal incision and sitting position varies depending on the eye, a helpful tip is to mark the location on the cornea with a marking pen prior so that one can line up with that spot when in the anterior chamber. Another important point is to ensure proper trabecular tissue engagement with the Hydrus Microstent cannula tip. The cannula tip should be placed against the top edge of the pigmented TM angled anteriorly about 15 to 20 degrees. You can score the TM with the tip, though this is not necessary, as you can also, with back pressure, advance the cannula tip through the TM until the bevel portion is confirmed in the Schlemm's canal. The entry of the stent should glide and be smooth. If there is significant resistance, check the positioning of the stent. The good news is that the Hydrus can easily be retracted and repositioned as necessary. Next, another important tip is to make sure that the AC is not overfilled with viscoelastic. This can flatten Schlemm's canal and cause difficulty with insertion of the cannula and the Hydrus Microstent. Instead, leave the AC filled about 15 to 20 millimeters of mercury. Too low of an eye pressure can cause striae, and too high, as I said, may collapse Schlemm's canal. One last point is to hold the cannula steady, keeping the tip engaged in Schlemm's canal. By docking the cannula tip, you have a higher probability of delivering the stent with 50% of the transition zone covered, minimizing the need to adjust the stent after deploying it. Well, that's all Hydrus Microstent tips for now. If you found benefit in that review of common errors and solutions for the Hydrus Microstent, please like the video and share with colleagues. We hope this video will help you on your journey to MIGS surgical success. Subscribe to the channel so you won't miss the next video in the series. Thanks for watching the Eye Glaucoma YouTube channel, a place for glaucoma innovation made easy for eye care professionals.